Hey everyone, Lex here. Just to remind you guys, I have a brand new channel out where I play GTA 5 mods and also things very soon like BeamNG and sim games and also just loads of different games in general that aren't Minecraft. If you want to go check that channel out, it will be a link in the description below and there'll also be like a card thing on the video where you can click there. But there we go, that's it. Enjoy the rest of this video. Greetings everyone, Lex here, and welcome back to another build showcase video built by Sachin. This is a huge map. I know we've been doing this for like 2 or 3 months on and off because I've just been sort of pushing these out when I can. And there's like 3 or 4 videos left, so we're getting very close to the end. Now this is what we looked at in the previous video, so if you want to go check this out in more detail, there is an interior and everything in this thing. Go check this out. So it'll be like a few videos back from this one. It's called the Detached House. So let's have a look at what we're going to be looking at today. We're going to be checking this out. Check that out. How amazing does this look? This is a fire station built with microblocks inside of the LexTube Let's Build Modpack. Let's just go around to the front and have another look at this. Look at that. I love those doors down the bottom there. Looks so amazing. So let's start from maybe this bit around the outside and then we move to the building and move up the building and see what's inside. I don't know if there is actually anything in there, but we'll see that at the end anyway. So this is from the start. This is how we get in. We've got these road markings. These are pretty cool road markings. Very British designed, of course. This is actually, this is round the wrong way. I've just noticed this seems to be round the wrong way. This would actually make you come in on the right and out on the right. Yeah, that's not right. I'm pretty sure that should be the other way around. Unless I'm... It's very early in the morning. I'm recording this at like 8 in the morning. So that's probably why I might make that mistake. But that looks like as if you were to be driving on the right, which is not very British. Oh, dear. Right, moving on. These are the fences that we've got around here. So we have these. These are white metal platforms. These are actually part of Railcraft. And they don't attach to the bottom because these are just standard brick slabs, so they're not going to attach. That's a pretty interesting design. I've not really seen something like that before. And we also have the same platforms going out here with these inverted white fixtures on top to have some sort of lighting going around the wall. We also have these. If we go over here, we have these inverted light grey lanterns as well. And these tops, although this might look like they're sticking out of the block, these are actually all within. Oh, actually, maybe they're not. Oh, whoa. Oh, okay. I've just discovered something brand new. So when we place this on the ground, in fact, we can't place it on that ground. Where can we place it? We can place it on that one. Let's just actually get a brand new block. Let's just start fresh on top of a block so we can see exactly what's going on here. Okay. So if we were to place this down, this has this little bottom bit on it, as you can see. And if you add that... Oh my god, I did not know that existed. You can actually place some microblocks inside the same block as that lamp and get rid of that bottom bit. How about that? That's something I didn't even know, so we've learned something brand new today. Right, moving on, we've got our zebra crossing going down here. And we've got this really nice quartz thing on the bottom. Now, there is no corner on here. It actually has very sharp corners. It'd be quite interesting if we were to have that. What is that at the bottom? We've actually got a bit sticking out the bottom. That is a cool thing. I don't think I've actually done that before. So it's also sort of bleeding into the floor. That's just another interesting design. Yeah, there is nothing on these corners which maybe would have looked better. I'm not sure if we can actually get these. These are, what are they? They're quartz posts. Let's just get ourselves some quartz. Like that. What I want to do is I'm going to grab... what do we need? Stone. What are they? It says quartz post. We want some quartz notch. That's classic stone quartz. I don't think that's the right one. It just says block of quartz. Okay, block of quartz. It's okay. There's a few different textures that are similar. That's why I'm getting a bit confused here. Right, let's just get these and let's just see what happens. So if we were to put that in there. There we go. Now we've... Actually, that's not the right thing. You can see the texture is a bit wrong there. But for the sake of this video, I'm just going to pop these in. And... Oh, actually, yeah. Why aren't they the right size? They're not the right size. Okay, this is going to become apparent where I haven't actually built in microblocks for a few months now. Maybe like half a year, I think, thinking about it. Oh, God, have we crashed? No, it's okay. Yeah, we're still in huge amounts of lag. This is one of the reasons why I just haven't built. It's because there's just so much lag in this damn thing. Which is why anyone who's built anything in this is clearly a very patient and cool person. Because I lost patience with this thing years ago. Or months ago, rather. Right, so let's just move out of that. Let's just ignore those corners. It would have been cool if we had those, but I don't know. I couldn't get them to match. But that might just be the whole early in the morning thing and I'm tired. So, we have these doors. These are very cool doors. Let's just check out the inside. There's not much on the inside. We just have all these doors going around here. We've got these black edges on them. More lag. Come on. Come on, computer. There we go. Wow. It is lagging so much. Oh, my goodness me. We've got this bit here, which sort of, like, goes in the middle. How? Okay, that's one full block. Then that must... Okay, that's just a pillar. That's just how... So, if we were to get that... Pillar goes there. That's how he's made that. That's pretty simple indeed. And he's got the same usual windows that I like to do in most of my builds that are British style. Is to use the quartz strip and the post and just build them up like that. But he hasn't put any sort of corner thing on the end. But we're not going to go through and adding stuff in because otherwise I'm just going to get a massive headache from this thing. Moving up here, we've got some sort of... What are these? These are quartz panels again and brick panels to get this nice border design going around the edge. And I like the way that this roof comes down here and gets to the same height as these. Oh, goodness me. From that inside, that looks very weird. Let's just jump inside. Where can we jump inside from? Over here. There is so much lag going on. Goodness me. He's actually installed some sort of like fireman style thing. We're just in a pole down in the middle. So this takes us up to the ceiling, and as you can see there, we also have this part of the roof with the windows is the same as this bit that isn't part of the roof with the windows as well. Oh, we've also got a staircase here. That's pretty cool. Oh my god, there's a guy here. There's a... Okay, that's one of those, whatever they are, armor things, statue things. I forgot they were even in this mod. Mod showcase, mod pack. That's the word I was looking for, mod pack. Goodness me, I probably should not record at 8 in the morning. It's too early, guys. Okay, right, yeah. So we have these. I like these lines going across here. We've got these more strips. They go in the way of the covers, and they would go like that. I just noticed, of course, because these are sticking out here, they're actually on the level with the block, as you can see there, and these bits are just that. So this bit of basalt thing is sort of sunken down a little. That looks a bit weird. Yes, all he's done with that is he's pretty much just built them like that. Maybe he's built them one more. No, that'd have been too big. So he'd have built them just the one like that. And that's how he's got that nice little effect. Very simple to do. That's something you want to try out. He's got this wooden door. This is made out from the carpenter's doors, and he's used this giant red flower texture in order to get the doors and the color. This was a very good one to use because it's sort of red, but it's not solid red, so you can get that texture and all that sort of stuff. And it doesn't really look like a flower, despite the fact it is a flower block. Let's just get rid of that yellow. It's a very awkward thing. There we go. So, as for the design of this thing, it definitely looks very cool. All these windows look very weird. It would be so interesting to see what this would look like with the interior finished as well, as with most of these builds that don't have the interiors with them. But it is an interesting looking build anyway. And I've just noticed these little bits in here. What a weird little window system this is. We can actually stand in here. That's pretty cool. So it's a window on both sides. And then we've got this strange random thing here, which is like hollow brick. We've got that with pillars in the middle. And then that on top. That is a really weird design. I don't know why that's there. Maybe, I don't know if this is based on like a real building or something like that, or whether he just built it from just his memory or built it from, I don't know. But that is a very weird looking design. I don't know what the deal is with that one. Let's move on to the roof. We've got a bunch of chimneys here and the roof is built up like that. So they're like standard block, pillar, standard block, pillar, standard block, pillar, standard block. And that's how he gets that sort of build, which is slightly more tall than if you were to build that. If we were to just go like that, that doesn't look right. He's actually got that bit in the middle, as you can see there. So you can see that it makes it look a lot steeper, looks a lot better, really do like using pillars and microblocks to get roofs in, because you just get nice, much better patterns, like that one over there that we'll be checking out in another video. But I think that's going to be it for this one. There's not much on the inside, but that's a pretty neat looking building anyway. There's actually not much to it. There's a few things. There's the middle bit here. There's the top bit here, as in different sections. Then there's the roof bit there. And then the door bit down the bottom there. That's pretty much it for the different elements of design that he's used inside this building. You can see that it's got the same thing going along on the sides. We've also got it sort of thicker out there, just to sort of break it up a little bit. And the same pretty much continues on the back with the open door as well. Of course, very good idea, because we only get tiny little doors inside of Minecraft. Building these doors that don't move but look like that just make buildings look so much better. So that's a really good top tip. But that's going to be it for this video. If you've enjoyed this video, please let me know by rating, commenting, and subscribing. We're also very close to getting rid of all of these videos and finishing them and moving on to something else. But that's it, guys. Thank you very much for watching, and I will see you all next time. Goodbye!